What's up, Cardboard Nation? Welcome to another episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. Hope you guys are doing well. Thanks for hanging out with us tonight. I'm your host, Rob Bertrand. Joining me as always, Ivan Lovgren.
Hey,
how you doing, brother?
More exciting, Rob, is that you're joining us from the start of the show.
How about that?
How are you doing?
I am doing much better every day. I think I've finally crossed the 90% back to normal threshold. So well on my way to being 100% by the time the national rolls around, which I think we're in official countdown mode at this point, right?
I mean, 3 weeks. 3 weeks from today, we will be on the stage. Wow, I didn't even realize that.
Ooh. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah.
I'm going to be getting on a plane. There's a few things I need to get in order still.
14, 15, 16, 17, 18 days till I get on a plane. Nice. Yeah, so that's going to be exciting. Hey, Rob, I was driving the kids home and we had a surprise for them and I spoiled it for them. Can I spoil the surprise for our viewers tonight?
Oh, please do.
Okay. It is not donuts, which my kids got from Winchell's, of course. It's not donuts, but we actually have a giveaway of tickets to the National. So that said, you're going to want to stick around for the entire show tonight because we have a 4-pack of National Sports Collectors Convention tickets for that show in 3 weeks. Wait, Rob, actually, did you see what the National did today?
Yeah, they said, hey, let's make it 8. So we're going to give 2 4-packs away. Obviously, gotcha. This will be a dedicated tweet and only retweet it and be eligible-fy yourself, if that makes any sense, if you can go to the National.
Well, obviously. So here's the thing. I'll create the rules right now, so it'll be free. It'll be easy. But first off, they are general admission one-day tickets. They are not the VIP tickets. So don't jump over yourself trying to flip these. These are for people that can go. That said, what I'll do, if you're new to the show, go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive, because in just a minute, our first show topic is going to be something pinned to our webpage anyways on Twitter. Go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive. All of you, retweet the tweet I'm about to put out with the National Sports Collectors Convention tickets. But if you want to win, retweet and then also reply with anything. What should they reply with, Rob? What should they tell us? Tell us who you are most excited to see, which company you're most excited to see at the National. Tops, Upper Deck, Panini, Loop, you know, Golden Auctions, Heritage Auctions, James Spence Authentication. Who cares? But tell us who you're most excited to see at the National. So I'll pull from the retweets, but I will verify that they also replied to that tweet. So that way we make sure that it's somebody that can go to the National that's replying. So is that fair?
Yeah, I think our viewers are smart enough to get that for the most part. I know we have to actually spell it out and say it, but I think for the most part, our peeps are smart enough to get it. But so what else is going to come into play is the Go GTS Live Q of the Week poll, which you'll have an opportunity to win hits from some of the boxes we're breaking tonight. We've got 3 different box break segments, 1 for Tops, 1 for Panini, and 1 for Upper Deck. So we wanted to know halfway through the calendar year, who has been the hobby star of the year so far, or to date, if you will. We put up a few choices: Shohei Ohtani, Trevor Lawrence, LaMelo Ball, and then other, please reply. And blowing away the rest of the field right now at 81.5% is Shohei Ohtani. So let's take a deeper dive into this with 341 votes. This poll comes courtesy of Ivan, but I modified it. He actually provided me 4 choices, and I don't know. He had to know I was going to go that direction and say, hey, we got it. We got to delete one of these and say other, please reply. But the one that has had its name replaced with other is getting a lot of good feedback and is also who I would make a case for. And Ivan wanted on the list, Lewis Hamilton of Formula One racing. So kind of interesting there that we kind of think alike, but we took different paths to get there, so to speak.
Well, I mean, with what Ohtani has done, you kind of knew. And then also just the fact that at least we know our audience is a bit more plugged into baseball than tennis, golf, Formula One, even soccer. While a lot of you are really plugged into those other things, we know in general the broader audience that we're connected to gravitates towards baseball first, probably basketball second.
Correct.
That said, I really wanted Lewis Hamilton on the poll because I have been a fan since his very first card came out just late last year and really took off this year, as well as Chrome and Dynasty and all the Tops Nows and how the impact has been of those. I think he's become a bit of a superstar, but I got why you put him as other. I love seeing the Lewis Hamilton crowd come out. But Rob, you were saying before the show that he was a hobby superstar for more reasons than Ohtani, more than just, oh, value, or more than just records.
I think given the fact that to the hobby audience as a whole, Shohei Ohtani is a much more known commodity. So the fact that Lewis Hamilton could have cards, be a star in his sport, but then immediately have his cards turn into something of value, something whose demand exceeds supply, if you will. That brought a level of excitement for me to the hobby, and leading the way is obviously the face of the sport right now, Lewis Hamilton. So that's why I thought a case could be made, but I certainly get Ohtani running away with this.
That's also funny, Rob, because at risk of losing half our audience by talking too much about F1 in the first 3 minutes, my one reservation when I texted you that response today was that the last five races, Lewis has not had a win and Max Verstappen has been just skyrocketing.
Well, someone even said that in the poll. Penguins fan 32, good on you, Luke, mentioned Max Verstappen. So I think the hobby and the global appeal of the hobby means that more eyes are on sports that we aren't the core four, if you will. You know, we've seen soccer become part of what now I think you can say is the core five, but there's still plenty of other sports like F1 out there that if people even spend 15 minutes watching, you can become a fan pretty quickly.
Awesome. Well, hey, so just a reminder, we do that because it's twitter.com/GoGTSLive where we will be giving away all of the hits from our box breaks tonight. So we want to make sure that you're following us there. Also, I'm on the page right now and there's only three responses still. So maybe we don't have a whole bunch of guys that are peeps watching that want to win. I mean, who out there needs to win some tickets? Make sure you take a minute, go to GoGTSLive on Twitter and reply and retweet the National Sports Collectors Convention tweets. I may have made it a little difficult because I also cheated and went in on the account and retweeted every Lewis Hamilton response right after posting. But it's like six posts down. Just scroll down the page if you want to win. If you don't want to win, that's fine. That said, make sure you're following us there because, Rob, we've got three box breaks tonight, one from each of the major manufacturers. Or no, three box break segments.
Yes.
With six box breaks. So we're going to have a lot to give away. We've got two hot in the shop segments because that's how much is coming out next week, including Topps Olympics trading cards. Talk about something, another cog in the collecting gears.
Deal. Yeah.
Yeah. And of course, we've got a pretty exciting segment coming up right now, Hobby Happenings. So let's get rolling.
Absolutely. So here is a look at some news, notes, and nuggets from around the web in a segment we like to call Hobby Happenings. Well, it would be easy to think that after last week's big news, Ken Golden and company might sit on their laurels for at least a week, but that's just not who Ken Golden is. The sale of Golden Auctions to Collectors Holdings, which, by the way, is the Nat Turner-led company that took PSA, parent company Collectors Universe, private earlier this year, Well, this provides some real insight into what the future has in store for the collectors holdings group. Meanwhile, Ken Golden continues to be a great voice for the hobby. Check out this new feature production from the newly created Golden Content titled The Card I Will Never Forget.
Hi everyone, my name is Samantha Shuford, and a card that I will never forget is this Luke Kuechly Topps Chrome Rookie. It is his Camo Refractor autograph, numbered out of 105. This card has a lot of value, and it's super important to me. And so having this card just brings back a lot of good memories of going to the Carolina Panther games with my dad, tailgating. This is a time when we had Luke Kuechly, and so we were decent, and we even went to the Super Bowl. The year after that he won Defensive Rookie of the Year, I went to the Carolina Panthers training camp, and I waited in line to get an autograph. And he actually waited and signed every single person. Ever since then, I've always had a connection and supported him throughout his time with the team. But it's one of the main reasons why I love that card. It's awesome. Also a gift, so I'm super grateful and thankful. So it's definitely a card that I will never ever get rid of because I enjoy it and have such a strong connection to it as well. And I will never forget.
So super slick, well done segment, getting people involved in the hobby, sharing their PC stories. I love that. Great stuff. But that's not all. As many of you know, Golden has hosted some of the most popular box breaks in the hobby on his own social channels. Now Golden has announced a partnership with Barstool Sports to host those breaks and other digital content. As reported by Sports Collectors Digest, quote, the partnership will build upon Golden's audience of millions of sports collectors and hobbyists by creating exclusive new content across Barstool's most popular programs and platforms. Barstool will create exclusive content for Big Cat, PFT Commentator, and Pardon My Take, including live stream box breaks. Golden will also bring coverage of the Red Hot Collectibles market to Barstool's passionate audience. Be sure to read the full article yourself for more details about this dynamic new partnership, and congratulations to both parties.
Well, the Golden acquisition as well as the Golden partnership news was certainly big last week. Check out this other bombshell acquisition from this week. The alternative asset platform, Alt, announced that they have purchased a 2009 National Treasures Steph Curry. Wait, not just a, the one of one rookie logo man autograph for a new all-time sports card record, not basketball, sports card, all of them, of $5.9 million. Wow. Watch this video.
Well, I, for one, am excited to announce that the 41st National Sports Collectors Convention auction, benefiting Signatures for Soldiers and powered by Handbid, is now open. Obviously, as longtime and big fans of the organization, we couldn't be more thrilled with the fact that the National has made Signatures for Soldiers and Military Missions in Action its official charitable partner. Please check out the numerous items available to bid on. Credit card registration is required, and there's also a place to donate items. Visit the URL on your screen, the bit.ly there we created, which is much easier than the URL itself.
We could probably drop that in the chat, couldn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. Need not be present to win. That's what's really cool about the Handbid auction app for charitable fundraising like Signatures for Soldiers is doing. Hey, speaking of the National, hopefully we'll see the Topps truck there, but guess what? Even if you can't make it, it's hitting the road tomorrow. That's right. Friday, July 9th, the Topps truck will be in Denver, Colorado to kick off MLB's All-Star Weekend, and then it'll travel to numerous cities, stopping at MLB stadiums, hobby shops, and local events across the country, finally ending at the Field of Dreams game in Dyersville, Iowa on August 12th. The Topps truck, which is wrapped entirely in over 11,000 baseball cards, Have we confirmed that there's a 1952 Mantle on there? Will travel more than 7,000 miles on its journey, bringing baseball fans the ultimate fandom experience. Throughout the month-long journey, the on-site teams in each location will host trivia contests and cornhole games. What else would you expect from a baseball card truck? And, of course, prizes of free baseball cards and Topps swag will be given away. Fans are also invited to take a photo in a life-size Topps card frame to become their own trading card. So it's not just for social purposes. You can actually get your own card, as well as trade at the mobile Topps card wall, a staple activity at Topps events. So bring a few cards to trade, bring your cameras, bring your A game for the cornhole. It's going to be a lot of fun with the Topps truck all across America this month.
Absolutely. It's starting off at Mike's Stadium Club. So congrats to Mike Fruitman. Some other national notes. We also started this year's attendees guide on the blog. So be sure to check that out at gogts.net. Onyx Authenticated has announced their first ever national VIP event. On the Thursday night of the show, July 29th, the company and its VIP ticket holders will take over the nearby Dave & Buster's in Rosemont, Illinois, for a three-hour Onyx Authenticated VIP party with guests including Baseball Hall of Famers Randy Johnson and Fergie Jenkins, as well as NFL stars Frank Gore and Chad Johnson. Ocho Cinco. In addition, each guest will receive an autographed Onyx Premium Limited Edition card for Johnson, Jenkins, Gore, and Johnson. No other signings will be allowed, as well as a VIP black box that includes one autographed card from an absolutely amazing list of retired greats, active stars, future stars, and more. Attendees will receive a swag bag, photo ops with guests, raffle tickets, and food and drink at the event. Congrats to Lance Fisher of Onyx and cheers to what I'm sure will be a great event.
Some stories in the hobby courtesy of Sports Collectors Daily include the Sports Illustrated cover story Tuesday focused on the hobby, more specifically our aforementioned 1952 Topps Mickey Mantle card. Writer Alex Pruitt dives into the card's history for SI, its most prominent and some of its newest owners, grading, the still mythical Rosen find, and the skyrocketing values. Readers also learn about another well-known athlete who's built a portfolio of high-end sports cards.
Love it when SI brings some hobby knowledge. Well, another hobby shop burglary. They got this guy cold, I think, though. This time in the Pacific Northwest, someone broke into the On the Mark sports cards in Kennewick, Washington last Thursday and stole thousands of dollars worth of singles and unopened material. Fortunately, there is video footage of the burglary, clear images of the suspect, and even some surveillance photos of the thief's car. So hopefully local police will catch this jerk. A local TV station talked with owner Donnie Marcourt about the incident. Watch this.
A Kennewick sports card shop is asking for the public's help to help find whoever broke in and stole thousands of dollars worth of merchandise. Today, I stopped by On the Mark to learn what happened and how the pandemic has placed a big demand on these cards.
For Donnie Marquardt, this store represents a dream come true.
I have fun coming to work, talking with people about sports and cards, and I love watching people open up really good cards. Right now is the huge market. I got in at a good time.
And this week, while most of us were just trying to survive the heat and local businesses attempting to stay open, he was cleaning up this.
He knew what he was getting. He went straight to the expensive stuff.
Around 8 a.m. on Thursday, Donnie went to his store, On the Mark Sports Cards, and discovered around $7,000 worth of cards gone.
It's tough. I mean, it's hard for me to find stuff, and now when stuff comes missing, it makes it even harder. The most expensive box he took was a box of Prism Basketball, which retails for $1,400.
Donnie says he feels violated, but it's not surprising.
With the sports card boom, stuff's gotten expensive, so I mean, I've heard of it going around the country everywhere.
Places like Target don't even sell cards in store anymore because of threats and fights, so the demand has fallen on stores like On the Mark.
I think people had extra money, they had time on their hands, I mean, with the stimulus checks. A lot of collectors that said they were collectors when they were kids are getting back into the hobby. I mean, it's just huge right now. It's more of an investment than a hobby now.
Some of the cards were one of a kind, so if they get listed online...
Obviously, we know it was mine. But yeah, I mean, and graded stuff all has certification numbers on them that are unique to the card.
Now you can support Donnie by visiting his store off of Gage Boulevard or his Facebook page. If you have any information on this incident or recognize the suspect, please contact the Kennewick Police Department.
A new YouTube series by the National Baseball Hall of Fame will help fans connect with the national pastime. The Hall of Fame announced a 13-episode series, Hall of Fame Connections, which will give fans a unique perspective of the museum in Cooperstown, New York. The series is being produced by MLB Network and received funding from New York's Division of Tourism. The series will be available to stream for free through the Hall of Fame's YouTube channel. Hey, talk about being progressive with the times. www.youtube.com/baseballhall. New episodes will be released each Wednesday through September and will also be featured across MLB Network's studio programming for those of you who like to watch on TV. Each episode will show how two seemingly unrelated artifacts in the museum are connected. Each two-part episode will feature the Hall's curators discussing the artifacts with former major leaguer and current MLB Network personality Carlos Pena, as well as sports journalist Lindsay Berra, the granddaughter of Hall of Fame catcher Yogi Berra. Here's a quick trailer for the series.
Camping World encourages fans to get out there and visit the National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum.
How does one of baseball's most celebrated plays connect to one of baseball's most notorious curses? Through a cross-country move, an earthquake, and the Men of Steel? Find out next on Hall of Fame Connections. Generational stars are expected to make extraordinary plays. Willie Mays was headed to Cooperstown regardless of whether or not he made an impossible catch in center field. But then there are players like Dave Roberts, who seize a moment and etch their names in history. Make a big play on the big stage, and we'll play it over and over again.
It was a defensive play so iconic that we simply call it the catch. The Cleveland Indians faced off against the New York Giants in Game 1 of the 1954 World Series. The game was tied at 2 in the eighth. With runners on first and second, Cleveland batter Vic Wirtz belted a deep fly ball 420 feet to dead center field. Willie Mays sprinted to the outfield wall at New York's Polo Grounds. He made a spectacular over-the-shoulder grab, then, in one fluid motion, spun and threw the ball back to the infield. His catch sparked the Giants to an extra-inning victory and a sweep of the World Series. Mays' glove would end up on display in the Hall of Fame, but it would be the final championship for the New York Giants.
More venture capital hitting the hobby. Sports Collectors Daily reports that a card collecting management software startup has received a new round of funding to accelerate the development of its platform. Noted venture capitalist Peter Thiel is behind the effort to boost Cardbase, a website and app that enables users to track and manage their sports card collections. Also participating in the round is Investacard, which is backed by millionaire investor and entrepreneur Marcus Lemon and Lucas Mast. The amount of the investment wasn't disclosed. Founded last year, Cardbase is headquartered in Mountain View, California, and is available on the web, iOS, and Android. The platform provides users with real-time alerts, valuations, and other relevant key metrics for each card they own, similar to an interface of an online stock portfolio. Interesting.
This next story is good for all those on the West Coast who say they can't make it to the National because of travel. and also for a completely different demographic. I mean, it seems like this might have, should have already happened, but now it appears official. The first ever, or at least first big sports card and sneaker show will be taking place this fall in Las Vegas. It's another sign that these two former separate collectible niches may be attracting the same type of collector. It will be interesting to see if this dual show type experience grows in popularity the way trading card and gaming card shows have in the past.
Too true. Hey, Ivan, I don't know if you saw this, but the first Chicago Cubs 2016 World Series player ring is set to hit the auction block next month as part of Heritage Auctions' annual Platinum Night event. The ring was awarded to one of the team's key players, Ben Zobrist. So you going to get in on that action, Ivan? Or,
I mean, have you read the story behind this?
Not in entire its entirety. Debacle?
Yeah. It's interesting. There's some interesting dispute stuff going on there. So check out, Google it.
Provenance issues, perhaps? Rightful ownership issues? Gotcha. Yep. Interesting.
Yeah, his agent specifically saying that he's not selling his World Series ring, while other people saying this is his World Series ring.
Wow. So I love a good controversy.
Yeah, so keep your eyes peeled for that story if you see more on that World Series ring.
Yes.
And if it turns out to be true and legitimate, send it to me after you win. Hey, we are excited to introduce, along with Panini, really it's their introduction, we're just sharing it, the largest NFLPA rookie premier class in 27 years. Why are we excited by that? Because that means more rookies from the rookie premier having autographs in product sooner, having better autographs, having more content for you. So with Panini America making some of the most promising and marketable new NFL players that were selected, they also bring them there to learn the business of football and help jumpstart their endorsement careers. So watch this about the NFLPA rookie premier this year.
And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Well, Ivan, so interesting about the World Series ring. Wonder what's going to become of that.
Yep, lots of stuff.
We've seen similar incidents happen where that when it actually came time for the auction to happen, that the auction company decided not to sell. So it'll be interesting to see what happens with this
piece. I mean, we even saw this week on Golden Auctions Instagram, a Michael Jordan that they withdrew from auction over not a memorabilia piece, but I don't know. I just always like when there's a little bit of honesty. And so a company coming out and saying, hey, we're not selling that because we want to make sure that we only sell good stuff, I think is a good sign for the hobby. The other thing that really jumped out at me from the hobby news, though, and it's been happening more and more, look at how much outside money is coming in to invest in infrastructure in the hobby.
Yep.
And I think that's so big.
It's, to me, it's telling that You know, everybody talking about a crash or a correction, yes, that'll eventually happen. But the amount of big money that's entering the hobby and backing this as a true market, if you will, to me bodes well for its long-term health. Hey, first of several live box break segments tonight. And my goal really was I wanted to have three different t-shirts on and change for each one, but I just didn't have the energy to go through with that tonight. In fact, I realized, wow, it's like 9:30. It's almost like past my bedtime. So I'm easing myself back into late night. So, two Topps products are going to kick off our box break segments tonight. One we've seen, in the form of 2020 women's division WWE. The second is season two of The Mandalorian and that adorable collectible tin. But, so we'll check that out in a minute, but I want to, give this a second look, just because, you know, this is right up my alley with the WWE's women's division.
Yeah, and if I recall, last time we hit some pretty good cards.
Yeah,
some numbered parallels, some good-looking autos. So hopefully we'll have that happen again, since each box is supposed to deliver one autograph and one relic card. But then again, there's also all those parallels. So you could get a non-auto that's pretty sweet, low-numbered.
So we've got a lot of matches and moments type cards that are base cards and then roster cards. Becky Lynch.
There are also autographed book cards possible, so that would be cool to see one of those. One's the four horsewomen of WWE. Bailey, Becky, Charlotte, and Sasha.
Nice. A lot of great talent coming up in NXT, so good to see them being represented, going back a little old school with that whole greatest moments, looking back at Ronda Rousey defeating Sasha Banks. So you can say, well, I'm not up on the roster and all the characters, because, you know, I go in and out of my interest in time consumption of viewing. But Tegan Knox, keep an eye out for her. A lot of colorful cards. So here's a green parallel. I'm going to finish off the...
They are a little high for the video, just a heads up, Rob, if there's any way to hold them lower.
Raquel Gonzalez rookie card.
I don't want you to strain it. It's tough, but...
No, I just had to adjust. We're good. Another rookie. Santana Garrett. Asuka. Superstar transformation. Asuka, Kairi Sane, Sasha Banks, Charlotte Flair, before and after. Alexa Bliss, Paige, then Breaking Barriers, China. All right, green parallel. That's number 75. Kairi Sane makes her SmackDown debut.
Oh, no, it's back. Well, move on to the next. It's not the greatest picture either, at least for the on the internet. It might be a good picture in person. It's just not quite super sharp.
We have
a small subject. There we go. Now that's
Matt used relic card of Mia Yim. And boom, on card, Alexa Bliss, numbered to 199. Two winners get the relic card and that green parallel number to 75 to one person, and the other person will get the beautiful Alexa Bliss auto. I have a rollover prize alert. I did get all the shipping done. Everything went out Tuesday after no postal service on Monday the 5th. So everything went out Tuesday. Only one unclaimed prize, and it's a doozy. It's the Shadowbox Auto of Alexander Barkov.
Oh, wow. Hey, real quick. Also, Rob.
I want to forget.
Is that an on-card auto? Or a sticker?
The Alexa Shadow Bliss. Box? No, Alexa Bliss is on-card.
Oh, oh yeah, that's for sure. That's awesome. All right, what is today? The 7/08/2021. All right, so we've got the Alexander Barkov Shadow Box auto. I got to put on there from Upper Deck. And then from this, we've got the Mia Yim Matt Relic.
Uh-huh.
Hey, what do you call a guy with no arms and no legs on the ground?
I don't know what.
Matt. And we've got the Alexa Bliss on-card auto. Absolutely awesome. Yes. Okay, so the tweet is live on GoGTS Twitter. So go to twitter.com/GoGTSLive. Retweet the wrestling tweet in order to enter to win. And then you also have to be watching the show when we announce the winners in order to be able to claim your prize. Or like the Alexander Barkov, it goes back into the prize pool. So we appreciate everybody who shares, even if they don't claim. But if you do want to win, you got to claim. So do that while we get into our next Topps product of the night. Topps Star Wars The Mandalorian Season 2 trading cards. Rob, have you watched this yet? I feel like we talked about this recently and you're still... Oh, man. All right. Well, I will translate for you then.
My mic is on.
Yeah, so I figured between good, the
yeah,
two
but,
of
but
you.
Rob, there's... James, you're not allowed to talk when it comes to Star Wars. There
I like The Mandalorian.
This. I know you do, but you also like Watto, so you're judging.
I like all the prequels, not just Watto.
Ah! Someone mute his mic. Where's the producer when I need him? That's it. We're looking for one autograph or sketch card, as well as, of course, parallels and inserts. And let's see who some of the signers are on the signers checklist while you get going on that.
There's regular sketch cards and, like, a cutout sketch card, right? Like, of his helmet, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ooh, should we get controversial with this?
There's a purple parallel. It's pretty. And then characters.
Moff Gideon. So good. So the autograph checklist. So, wow, there's dual and triple autographs in this, which would be pretty cool.
Hey, isn't she, wasn't she on Third Rock from the Sun?
The female lead? No, that's a different actress. That's,
well, she's not the female lead, but was she? That's
I think that's Katie
nine.
Sackhoff, right?
Yeah.
Oh, Katie Sackhoff. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not the female lead from Third Rock from the Sun, whose name I don't know.
But was Katie Sackhoff on Third Rock from the Sun?
Maybe.
I think she was.
Here's that's a cool card. Parallel. I like that blue one with him with the Darksaber. Little baby Yoda down there.
I mean, who would collect all 12 The Child insert cards? Look at that. I don't even know about this.
Adorable.
That's a cool card. I'd take that. That's awesome.
So what I want to see is Gina Carano on the checklist for autograph signers? And is Mercedes Lewis, more commonly known as Rob? Rob?
I don't know.
Or no, sorry, Mercedes Vernado. Why did I come up with Mercedes Lewis? Mercedes Vernado.
Oh, man. I think I showed it already.
Yeah, I think I saw it too.
A blue parallel. Wow. How about this for a boom, Ivan? Numbered to 25.
Nice.
Oh, sinister. Moff Gideon numbered to 25.
Giancarlo Esposito. I would have loved his auto from a Breaking Bad box. That's awesome.
Sharp.
Wow. Doesn't get that much better than that.
It doesn't, except, Rob, I was trying to get to the fact that Mercedes Varnado is more commonly known as Sasha Banks, and she was in The Mandalorian Season 2. So I feel like you would appreciate an autograph of her also.
I would, yeah. Blue Parallel.
So, of course, Pedro Pascal as the Mandalorian is probably the number one chase in this. But, man, Giancarlo Esposito with a
Gina second. Carano's not in the set.
Incredible turn. Would be an incredible autograph to pull as well. Were you muted for that, or were you live, James?
I'm okay. Live.
Yeah, so that's what I was looking for, because there's been a little bit of canceling going on, political canceling going on in Star Wars world. Gina Carano being the first, and talk of Sasha Banks, Mercedes Varnado possibly being the second.
Oh, really?
And yeah, because she's come out and said some things that ruffled a few feathers. So I'm looking at the sell sheet, and the sell sheet had a Cara Dune autograph on it, but I'm looking at the checklist, and I do not see Cara Dune listed on the autographs.
Get right, your pens out. Start writing letters.
What do you think about that, James?
We should, hit an auto.
Should people get canceled?
Oof, this is not the place to talk about that. But here we go. No, hold on.
Artwork cards.
Oh, I thought that was a sketch. It looks really cool, though.
I thought it was, too.
Yeah.
I thought it was, too.
Sorry, I'm trying to download. The checklist is down. I have to download it to double check what I was just saying, so that's why I wasn't able to check on that exactly.
All right, so.
But I think those are like one per box, maybe? Those art cards.
Giancarlo Esposito as Moff Gideon, numbered to just 25. Sweet. All right, so that is the first of three box break segments for this evening. We'll check back in a little bit to segment two, which will feature Panini products. We'll detail those in just a few minutes. But first, want to update the poll question. Not that I'm expecting too drastic of a change. Halfway through the calendar year, who has been the hobby star of the year so far? Shohei Ohtani increasing his lead, 81.9% with 408 votes. Wow. Still an hour left. Running away with it.
But at the same time, what's the total breakdown? Did others shoot any higher?
Other did not shoot any.
Okay.
7.6%, but it's higher than the other two. LaMelo Ball at 6.9, Trevor Lawrence 3.7.
Here I thought Trevor Lawrence would be
meaningful. Get a little bit more love.
But yeah, I mean, he got his own set, and he's driving how many different, like, we haven't even talked about Wild Card. Did you see this whole thing with Wild Card? I don't even know what's going on there. What's going on there? No one tells me anything.
Hot in the shop this week is Wild Card. Why don't we shift gears to a video segment? To me, when you've made it in business, you end up on Varney and Company on Fox Business. And so when I saw Ezra Levine, CEO of Collectible App, as a guest and explaining fractional investment to one Mr. Varney, I just had to watch, and I thought you guys would enjoy it too. Check this out, and we'll be right back for the first Hot in the Shop segment. First one of two this evening. Watch this.
Dean is with us, and Ezra is the CEO of Collectible, which is described as a fractional investment platform for sports. Okay, Ezra, I can't afford $6 million. You're offering fractional shares. How do I get into this thing?
That's right. We are the stock market for high-end sports collectibles, right? We take the most iconic blue chip sports memorabilia, cards, memorabilia, and we make them accessible, digestible, and liquid for people of all income brackets all across the country. Our mission and our company's thesis was really proved over the past couple of days, where we consigned the 1914 Babe Ruth Baltimore News pre-minor league rookie card for a historic record-setting price.
Oh, wait a second. Okay, you paid $6 million for it, and now you're offering shares in that Babe Ruth pre-rookie card. Is that, that's how you're doing this thing? And the shares are 20,000 of them for $3 each? Is that it?
A private buyer bought the card for an excess of $5.2 million. That represents an industry record, right? The previous highs were tied by a Mickey Mantle card and a LeBron James card, both are $5.2 million. A private buyer bought this for an excess of $5.2 million. And we are listing the asset on our platform for $6 million. And we are selling $60,000 worth at $3 per share.
I don't get it. You're selling $60,000 worth. That's it. So I pay $3. I get a very small share. Can that the value of my share go up or down?
Correct. Yeah. So think of this as the stock market for sports collectibles, right? In the same way how you could own Facebook, for instance, on the public markets, you know, one share is around $300 at the moment, right? You don't own the entire business, but you own one share of it. It's the same concept applied to the world of collectibles. You can now own shares in the most rare and iconic assets in the world of sports collectibles.
But the owner of those collectibles, in this case, the owner of the pre-rookie Babe Ruth 1914 card, the owner comes to you and says,
oh. Same concept applied to the world of collectibles. You can now own shares in the most rare and iconic assets in the world of sports collectibles.
But the owner of those collectibles, in this case, the owner of the pre-rookie Babe Ruth 1914 card, the owner comes to you and says, okay, open it up to other investors. So the owner of the collectible has to come to you to make it into a kind of a stock market, right?
That's correct. Yeah, we take previously illiquid assets and make them liquid, right? We've created a stock market for sports collectibles. Our mission is to modernize this amazing industry of collectibles, right? It historically has been an incredible asset class. It's been an incredible place to invest. The issue has been that it's never been democratized before. It has never been available to people of all income brackets all across the country and soon all across the world. Collectible, our platform, allows people to gain exposure to this burgeoning asset class in a way that has never been possible before.
Ezra, we gave you a great commercial, and you picked up on it very well, I got to say. Collectible CEO Ezra Levine, thanks for joining us, sir. We do appreciate it. Good luck with that, too.
Thanks so much.
All right, let's check out some products that are sure to be hot in the shop when they release next week. Also be able to find them online at your favorite online retailer or group breaker. We kick things off with 2021 Topps U.S. Olympic trading cards, canceled last year
due to no Olympics.
one autograph card, two relic cards, 24 parallels, and 24 inserts in every box. Celebrate Team USA and its Olympic and Paralympic team and hopefuls with an all-new trading card set. Hopefuls. I always found that interesting, just in case someone doesn't make the team but was a big name, they'd want to get in there. Anyway, one autograph card in every box. There's also autograph base card parallels, limited silver 50, U.S. flag 25, gold 20, and foil fractor one of ones. Olympic champions, past Olympic medalist autographs. The checklist just came out, and it's on the website. Be sure to check it out. That'll be interesting to see what past Olympians are on the list. And then two relic cards, including Team USA memorabilia pieces, as well as several different commemorative pieces of memorabilia as well. Like I said, the checklist is up on GoGTS.net, and this will be in stores next week.
Also in stores, we have some exciting baseball product, 2021 Topps Museum Collection baseball cards. Each box is going to have four mini boxes, and inside of those, there will be two autographs, two relic cards, one of which will be an autographed relic card, and one of the autographs being signed on card. So quite a few little guarantees in there in the base box. But then there's also some guaranteed case hits, including one museum collection framed autograph card and one jumbo relic autograph card per case. Some other cool stuff that you'll see in there. There's the museum framed autograph card with a wood parallel. So we've seen gold and silver frames in the past. Well, this year there will be wood parallels. How cool is that? Also look for a quad relic. Some cool autographs, such as the Canvas Collection autograph card with some art of the player. A 100 card base set to chase with that classy museum feel. There's also Atelier autographed book cards, which will feature on-card autographs and iconic images of the best artists and their ballpark workshops. No idea what that looks like, but that'd be cool to see. As well as dual on-card autographs, triple on-card autographs, and other exciting jumbo patch type hits, including lumber bat nameplate relics. There's over 50 bat barrel nameplates, Rob, from game used bats. So each of those is a one of one, but there's over 50 of them spread across this product. So a lot of good content dropping in museum collection, not just what we're used to coming into hobby shops this week.
Also from Topps, we're going to get Archive Signature Series baseball cards, retired player edition, one encased autograph buyback card in every box featuring a colorful autograph checklist highlighted by some of the most iconic names in baseball history. Every card is hand signed, sequentially numbered, and enclosed in Topps authenticated casing. Just look at some of those classic cards. I would love to have and own every one of them. So again, as a reminder, every card is signed on card. Every card is numbered. Every card is enclosed in Topps authenticated casing. Every card is gold foil stamped with the 2021 Archive Signature Series logo. Oh, and also look for rare multi-signed autograph cards like that beauty in the middle right there. In stores next week, the checklist is also up and live on GoGTS.net.
And we've got a super fun collector product for baseball collectors, the vintage feeling throwback of Gypsy Queen baseball cards in hobby shops this week. Each hobby box is going to deliver two autographed cards along with seven insert cards. This is a set that has base set short prints, so keep your eye out for those. There will be one per hobby box. And one Gypsy Queen chrome box topper pack in every box. Some of the new content this year includes Captain Minis and autographed version of those Captain Minis, and the return of the rare autograph lineup cards.
Cool.
Yeah. There's a number of parallels as well, including burnt umber, orange, and sepia. Keep an eye out for photo variations, including Jackie Robinson Day photo variations, the Negro League Centennial Celebration photo variations, and much, much more. And then, of course, there's inserts like the Tarot of the Diamond cards. What else is there? The Captain Minis we talked about, art variation cards numbered one of one, where they've provided a sort of blank canvas to various top certified artists. So they'll be hand-painted flared one of ones of those Tarot of the Diamond art cards. And there's a hobby exclusive black and white parallel. So make sure you're ripping hobby boxes of this, not just what you can find at your local Target. So check out Topps Gypsy Queen this week.
Yeah, do that. All right. And that's our first Hot in the Shop segment. We'll circle back with three additional products releasing next week in a little bit. But first, we're going to dive into the second box break segment for this evening, featuring Panini products, including a product that Ivan has been chomping at the bit to break on the program. 2021 Panini Chronicles soccer cards.
Ooh, this is going to be fun.
As well as 2021 Panini Contenders draft picks collegiate football cards. We'll kick things off. I'm not going to wait, make Ivan wait any longer.
Chronicles it's only been 5 weeks.
Soccer. This breaks for you, Ivan.
Awesome. Hopefully I can know the actual names of the guys, because this is a deep league, deep product. There's actually three different leagues represented here. The Premier League.
We should have a box each of Premier League.
It's got the little symbol down
on top. La Liga and Serie A, which is Italy. And La Liga is Spain, correct?
Yeah.
I'm doing good. And obviously English Premier League. Do you have a preference of which league we open first?
Nope. Just rip into them and we'll see if we see anybody we recognize. I will say one of the challenges of this product is how deep the checklist is. Can make it a little tough sometimes. I'm slightly jaded. I don't know. You probably didn't see my experience.
Here
I pulled a one of one autograph of a guy that hasn't been in the league for 4 years. And I was like, what? Come on.
All right, here we go.
But that said, there are a lot of other players that are still in the league with some very, very hot cards that you could pull from this.
Here's a rookie of Tommy Tommaso Fobega.
Fobega. And this is why soccer is fun for a lot of people, because you could be collecting you could be a deep fan of one of these leagues or one of these teams, and you could be prospecting a guy that the rest of the world still isn't going to know about until the World Cup next year. There you go, from Bologna FC, Nicolas Dominguez. He looks pretty young, maybe has a future. Victor Osimhen. Sorry, I'm actually behind because I'm walking.
That's all right. Here's a rated rookie of Mert Mulder.
I like him just for that. Mert Mulder.
Rookie of Gianluca Scamacca. Leaf certified design. Rookie from Torino. We've got Sasa Lukic.
It looked like it might have been a gold version, too. Oh, Pedro, not Pedri. So, but again, it all comes down to the name. Some of the gold versions are 10 cents. Some are $100. That last guy you pulled, Pedro, nothing particularly special about him, but one of the hottest rookies in this is Pedri. It's actually pronounced Pedri. But Matthias Svanberg.
Rodrigo De Paul.
Prism. That was a base prism, though, not a silver, right?
Correct. Luca Ciagarini. Rookie Lucien Ogami.
Looks like it's an extra points rookie also, so that's always a little bit rarer.
Marco Pejac. And Mauro Tasso T. AC Milan, numbered to 500. This is a National Treasures auto. It looks like he's older. Like, was this back in the day or something?
Yeah, tell me the first name again.
Mauro Tassotti. Tassotti.
So he is an Italian manager now, former footballer who played predominantly as a right back. He currently is the assistant coach of the Ukraine national team and played with Milan for 17 years.
Wow. Okay.
So he's got a pretty strong history in the league. I got that feeling looking at his card too, that might be one that at least a soccer fan would really like.
Yeah, appreciate just from a historical perspective, right?
Mm-hmm. Looks like they aren't breaking the bank. You can get them for $10 on eBay.
This is the English Premier League. But
that's the other fun thing. I hate to ever hang our breaker friends out to dry, but sometimes they rip a product like this so that you, the collector, can get the $10 auto if you're not chasing Pedri, right? You know, there's multiple facets to the way that collecting works. I think absolutely it's overlooked. Still, we would love that David Beckham silver ticket from...
Here's a silver prism rated rookie of Dara O'Shea.
Not familiar with him either.
Oh, let's see. Lots of good looking cards out of Chronicles as always. A chance to see what the different brands would look like. Alex McAllister, rated rookie. Connor Gallagher, rookie. Will Smallbone, rookie, and a redemption for Prestige Premier League Extra Points Autographs Gold of Oliver McBurnie. Oliver McBurnie. Wonder what the autographs gold means. It's number 250, maybe?
Plays for Sheffield United. He's from Scotland originally. Ollie McBurnie, as he's affectionately known.
And our last mini box will be La Liga.
Looks like those golds might be out of 10.
Wow, that'd be cool.
Yeah, that's what speculation is. Because the base golds are out of 10 in this product. And there seems to be one on eBay. There's also some non-10 extra points autos as redemptions out there. So yeah, pretty cool hit there. Especially because is it two autos per box or is it one auto per box? Bonus auto? I got to get back to the product sheet now.
Raul Gute, rated rookie.
Jumping all over the place.
This really looks like a certified gold.
One of those donuts. Oh, yeah. So it's three autographs or memorabilia cards, but no guarantee that you would get two autos and one memorabilia versus getting one auto and two memorabilia, which is what I've seen many, many times from this product, is just one auto and two mems. So.
And our memorabilia card is numbered to 500 of Luka Modric.
So this is literally the first player whose name I've known in this entire box, but he is a great one. Luka Modric won the Ballon d'Or, the golden nice. Boot. He had the most goals in the last World Cup, even though Croatia lost the championship to France. Now he's a bit of a vet. He's like 35 years old now, but had a pretty good showing in the Euros just recently. Is a long-term superstar, possibly the greatest Croatian to ever play soccer. So, as a relic, that's not a bad one at all.
So three winners will give away the relic. We'll give away the redemption for Oliver McBurnie and Mauro Totti. All right. Next up, contenders, draft picks, football cards. We took a look at this several weeks ago, had a second box. Also remember, we didn't hit anything too major. I felt like we left something on the table, maybe. So let's see if we do any better. I mean, with the draft class like we have, the checklist like it is, come on, I want to hit one of those big backs.
Oh, apparently there was also a good rookie in there, Yunus Musa, that I missed at the
He was the first card out of the third box.
Yes, that was when I was looking up comps on that Ollie. If it was just the base rookie, though, it's not a crazy big card. But it's fun to see a second name. So there was two names in that box that I recognized. Now let's see how many in this Panini Contenders draft picks are. Hey, Aaron Rodgers, I recognize that name. Michael Carter, I don't recognize.
Oh, look at that. From the University of Notre Dame. I'm so bad at pronouncing his name. I'm not even going to try. Michael McManus is going to tease me probably.
Bad, but excited to...
A gun delay.
But excited to pull a guy from your team, right?
Absolutely.
So how many autos are in this box again? This is Contenders draft pick, six autos. Okay. So you're going to have to let me know what it is that's good. Obviously, I know a few names. But let me know what we're giving away when you see it, when you know it, when you feel it.
College ticket. Kellen Mond, quarterback for Texas A&M, right?
Yep.
The Vikings got him. All right. Devontae Johnson. Since we've already taken a more detailed look at this on a previous episode, that's why I'm being quick with the product. Usually I would give all the players their due. Inserts in the middle and always turning of the cards. Get so tired of that. Campus legends, passing yards. Florida State. Hamza Nasruddin, a safety. Whew. They recruit good defensive backs, though. Terry McLaurin, campus ticket. Baker Mayfield. Campus legends, Patrick Mahomes. School colors, Trey Lance. Jonathan Abrams Jr. Wideout from, who is that? What logo is that?
No numbered so far either in our first four, huh?
Yeah. We've usually done much better with this product. That's cool. What is that? Playing the numbers game. Jordan Smith. What is that? Out of Baylor? No. Can't tell. Defensive end.
Is that... Yeah, what school is that?
I'm going to put on some glasses and see if I can take a...
American singer from Harlan, Kentucky.
UAB.
One season nine of the Voice. Oh, wrong Jordan Smith. UAB. Plays for the Jacksonville Jaguars now. That's played cool. At Florida, Butler, CC, and then UAB. So he transferred. That's Alabama, Birmingham, I believe. UAB.
All right. Deion Jackson, running back from Duke. Deion Jackson. And then we have a conference finals ticket, number 99 of Damian Harris for the Crimson Tide. Cam Newton. All right. So, wow. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One winner.
All right. All the hits?
Yep.
Nice. That's what we do when the fire ain't fire. We just give it all away. So remember, go to twitter.com/goGTSLive to enter to win. You win by retweeting the tweets that are up that will say, hey, retweet and watch live to enter to win.
All right. So second part of Hot in the Shop. A look ahead at next week's new product releases. Let's go racing with Panini Chronicles Racing, 3 autograph cards and 1 memorabilia card, plus 2 Spectra cards in every box. Chronicles is going to feature top drivers like Haley Deegan, Chase Elliott, and Denny Hamlin across numerous sets, giving collectors a large variety to hunt for. Remember, Chronicles is that player collectors just chase extraordinaire. 3 autographs, so numerous sets from popular programs like Obsidian, Gold Standard, Select, and more. Plenty of opportunities to collect the penmanship of your favorite drivers. Also, Contenders Optic. Look for on-card autograph from 20 accomplished drivers. And then Cornerstone Material Signatures. Proud to announce that Chronicles is the first program to feature one of the greatest drivers to get behind the wheel, Jeff Gordon, and you can pick up his Cornerstone Material Signature cards in this product. 1 memorabilia card in every box, lots of race-worn and race-used material to be had in Chronicles Racing.
We've got an exciting football product this week for you football collectors as well. Donruss Elite is back for 2021, and every box has 2 autographed cards, 1 memorabilia card, as well as 3 rookies, and of course a plethora of parallels and inserts. You can chase some of the first rookie cards with updated NFL marks and photography of future stars like Trevor Lawrence, Justin Fields, Devonta Smith, and many more. Check out some of the cool stuff that's in here. Of course, Pen Pals autographs, which feature both single and dual autographs. So that will be 2 autographs of some of the top rookies. And then check out those Moxie inserts. You know, Panini keeps trying to bring it with super short print, stunning case hits to chase. Well, there's those Moxie inserts, but then there's also the Playmakers insert, which is a hobby exclusive. And of course, a beautiful looking base set to chase. Other cool inserts, including those Stars Jack Playmakers. There's the Playmakers. There's also Razzle Dazzle Parallels, which will be super short printed. So I don't know if those will be not numbered, super short printed Razzle Dazzle Parallels. So no note on what the numbering would be, but those look pretty freaking awesome. So again, chase the rookies, chase them in those NFL marks on the PayPals, Pen Pals logo, Freudian collector slip that any of us would make with Donruss Elite Hot in the Shop this week.
Our last product, I'm really excited to talk about. I'm a big fan of what Kevin Hefner does at Historic Autographs, and this is right in my wheelhouse. 1945, the end of World War II trading cards. More than 75 years ago, the world was embroiled in a horrific struggle as power split into two sides, the Allies and the Axis, and fought around the globe. Historic Autographs has chronicled the year 1945 because of the monumental importance of the end of World War II. The trading card series tells the year-long story of one of the most influential years in world history. Although centered around the events of World War II that occurred in 1945, other events, people, sports, and achievements are also highlighted. This comes in two different configurations, a hobby version, which will have 3 to 4 premium hits, plus a 5x7 metallic holographic crack and peel World War II sticker, as well as a comprehensive 42-page checklist pamphlet in every hobby box. And then the blaster configuration is going to deliver one premium hit in every blaster as well. Approximate odds per pack of finding some of these amazing pulls: DNA hair cards, 1 in 900. Dog tag relics, 1 in 27. Cut autographs, 1 in 44. Pilot autographs, 1 in 313. Challenge coins, 1 in 50. Printing plates, 1 in 210. Aurora parallels numbered to 45, 1 in 10 packs. 1-of-1 art cards, 1 in 610 packs. 1945 U.S. coin cards, 1 in 97 packs. And worn uniform relics, 1 in 14 packs. 146 card base set with subsets. Factory sets are limited with both Allies and Axis versions, both numbered to 299. The factory sets will come with 146 cards, all in a radiant parallel version, plus 3 alloy parallels and an Aurora parallel, for a total of 150 cards in each factory set. So whatever your price point, get in on this. Factory sets, blasters, and hobby boxes. This looks absolutely amazing, Ivan, don't you think?
Yeah, you had me at hair.
Right? I mean, this just, I mean, I can't wait to talk to Kevin at the National about this product, because it's just, it's phenomenal. I mean, it looks amazing. Looks amazing. I'm going to have to get some, I think, when I'm at the National. And that's a look at what's going to be hot in the shop. All right, our last box break segment for this evening is going to feature a twofer from Upper Deck, in the form of our, what we're going to break first will be SP Game Used NHL Hockey. Ooh. And we'll follow that up with SP Game Used Golf. How about that?
I like it, especially because Game Used always has such unique content in it. There's the Frameworks jersey die cuts, which are Swatch relics like we're familiar with, but cut in a jersey shape, which looks pretty cool, like how you would frame a jersey. Nice. There's neck cord cards. I know we've pulled some of those in the past. There's the pucks with the little autographs on the puck, which I think is so cool. Banners from the 2019 Tim Hortons NHL Heritage Classic, as well as the 2020 NHL Stadium Series and Winter Classics. So lots of cool content to chase in here. Inked sweaters, that'd be cool. Pulling a patch or a tag parallel numbered as low as 101. So get ripping 6 cards per pack, 1 pack per box. So it's going to be fast, but it's going to be furious. Ooh, banner year. I'm looking ahead. I'm seeing that. I hope that that's a banner piece.
Jonathan Toews numbered to 265.
Nice.
Authentic rookie Kirill Kaprizov numbered to 299.
Hold that for a second.
Huge.
Lean it down just a bit because the top edge is out of frame. Other way, like back. There we go. Now I got a full card.
Oh, I didn't know we were cropped that tight tonight.
Yeah. Croppy McCroppersons.
Authentic rookies auto Timothy Legegren from the Toronto Maple Leafs. Nicely done.
Is that one numbered somewhere on there too?
No.
Oh, interesting.
All-Star Skills, Nathan MacKinnon and Jack Eichel. Very cool.
Ooh.
Dual jersey card right there.
Yeah, that's not a relic card anyone's going to complain about getting.
Alexander True authentic rookie jersey for the San Jose Sharks. And yeah, jumbo banner year from the NHL All-Star Game. Seth Jones.
Nice, from the Blue Jackets.
Yeah, so we're definitely going to give that away. We're going to give this away. That, you know what? We're going to give it all away, except the Jonathan Toews base card. All right.
So who is the Alexander True? Was the relic?
Yes, Alexander True.
We've got Timothy, the dual McKinnon.
Yep, you got that.
Okay. McKinnon, Eichel. Then when you, who's Timothy?
Timothy L-I-L. Let's just go with that. Legigre. And then
it's Susan's brother.
Kirill Kiprusoff.
And then the Kaprizov rookie.
1, 2, 3.
Yep, that's 5. 4. 5 out of the 6 cards. All right, cool. Give me just 2 seconds to post that tweet. Are you able to look at the game, the box a little bit on that other one?
No problem.
Talk about that a bit.
All right, set that over there. Let's take a look at that beautiful rollover prize while we're at it. Shadowbox autograph, Alexander Barkov from our look at SPX last week. Right. Our last box break of the evening is going to be SP Game Used Golf. Collect at least 2 hits per box. We did very well with a Danielle Kang dual relic and a relic auto last week. How awesome would it be if we had a tiger in here? Could there be a tiger waiting? Is there a tiger just chomping at the bit to break out of that box?
We'll see. 2 to 3 memorabilia or autograph cards. So we've got a good shot. There's also Arnold Palmer, Jack Nicklaus, Annika Sorenstam.
We'd be happy with any of those.
Yeah. Bryson DeChambeau, one of the rising stars. Justin Thomas. Which ones are the ones that are always beefing with each other on Twitter or on Instagram?
I don't know. Is there
golf? Yeah, golf has gotten really. There's been a lot of jawing going on in golf lately. Have you noticed that, James? Are you paying attention to the golf side? No, to the golf, like not to the show.
I'm paying attention to the show, and I'm paying attention to this golf stuff. Well, there was that celebrity match with Tom Brady and Aaron Rodgers.
I think I feel a huge card right off the bat.
Thickie, you got a thickie in there.
Yeah.
Oh boy, look at this. Wow. Oh my gosh. That's please take a picture of that for Instagram.
8 out of 10?
Annika Sorenstam leaderboard letter mark card.
Oh my.
Gold autograph numbered 2. What is that number 2?
10. It's 10? 8 out of 10.
Wow.
10. Holy cow, this product has been so on fire to us. Unbelievable. Oh, that's a tough one to give away. Wow.
I'm not sure if...
Take a picture of that one for Instagram, though. It'll live on our Instagram page.
Sure. Is 4 or is hole-in-1 the best thing to put with that? Hole-in-1 just isn't the same, but I don't want to give the wrong impression with 4. But yeah, pay attention. That is right out the gate. We don't even need to look at the rest of the box.
Danny Willett front fabrics.
But see, look, that game used. Awesome.
Yeah.
Look at that. And front 9 fabrics.
I love the design.
Now, I wonder if it's actually from the front of the shirt and there's a back 9 fabrics with the back of the shirt. That'd be
remarkable.
You wouldn't even be able to tell if they were telling you the truth or lying, but man, I think that'd be cool. Hey, there, we mentioned Julie Inkster in this product. There she is.
Yep. And how about a rookie, Harold Varner III?
Oh, nice.
And then we are going to close it out with some tour gear cards. This one's a combo featuring Nick Taylor and Danny Willett.
Cool.
And the second one is a duel of Michael Thompson.
There we go. So only one autograph out of our three hits. Who's complaining? Not me. Annika Sorenstam, numbered to 10 autograph. Wow. Rob, what are we doing for giveaways? Just that or any of the other cards from that?
I'm going to give all the rest of the cards to one winner.
All right. Sounds good. So two winners. One's getting all the rest of that box. Golf box, and one is getting the Annika Sorenstam gold auto. Hey, we don't have a whole lot of time left, and we've got only a very short video segment. So I tweeted out the Annika Sorenstam on its own. Looks like that may be a $600 or $700 card. $850. What? Kidding me. So just make sure that you retweeted the original broadcast of the show on Twitter, the live broadcast of the show on Twitter. It should be pinned to the Twitter page right now. I'll add that to the giveaways that we pull from. So anybody that entered that will be eligible for the Annika Sorenstam as I start drawing all these winners and Rob shares the next segment.
Yeah, absolutely. I was trying to get a picture of that for you. And let's see. You're welcome. It'll be coming shortly. While Ivan is pulling all the winners for tonight, Travis Etienne from Clemson is a Panini rated rookie. Check out his journey. We'll be back to announce the winners after this video.
God works in mysterious ways. It's kind of crazy how far football has taken me and how much I've been able to see because of football.
Shipping and shaking, I'm staying where I'm safe. Couple spots, I don't know where I stay at. Why would you play? You know we don't play that. Flipping words when you know I ain't say that. I've been good, so I'm guessing it's
pain. Rated rookie, yeah. First trading card, my man give me right for my trading card.
Got you.
You go a long way.
Bought another car, then another one. Bank account like I just want a settlement. Sipping walk, I'm indeed into medicine.
That'll be a real big boy move. Rock away this in the game. Video game like, kind of crazy that I'm in NFL. Or we see my man over there, Trev, getting fresh, nice. NFL quarterback just looks the part. I mean, he got the nice white icy bottoms, man. Adidas cleats couldn't do any better, you know. It's crazy because I'm looking at his new uniform and like, wow, he's actually a quarterback for the Jacksonville Jaguars. It's a mood, I'm telling you. About to get some handoffs from my guy Trev. You know, some we practice so many times, but get it on film.
Feels good. It's what I'm used to. So it's one thing I don't have to get adjusted to. So it's been awesome.
Got gun double right, 95 read on one. Ready?
It's been awesome having Travis here. Obviously, we've known each other for 3 years now, and being able to hang out, you know, outside of here, but also just have a guy in the building that I've played with for the past 3 years. It's just, you know, adds a little bit of comfort coming somewhere new, and we're just really excited to do something great in Jacksonville.
Just life as a pro has been really great. I mean, learning the playbook at two positions has kind of been challenging for me, just playing a running back position for so long, since I was a little kid. So now just like kind of just learning real receiver routes, and having Trev here. To go just do simple things as like run routes outside and just kind of just go over it by ourselves has really been great for him and really helped me just speed up that process. Jaguars fans has been really great, just really been supportive since I've been here. I mean, it's really cool just to see how many fans they actually have. And I mean, just getting ready to provide big plays for Duval Nation.
Jacksonville is really growing on me, really affirmed the water. Lots of bodies of water around here, so I mean, that works out well for me. Went fishing with Trevor this past weekend. Finally caught my first fish, so I was very excited for that. And I mean, just can't wait to get back on the water, really. So Jacksonville's really growing on me. Number one was a great choice. At first, I really wasn't sold on it, but now looking at it in my official uniform, I made a great decision.
I'll see you in there. I'm gonna warm it up for you. I'm gonna warm up the 10.
Every time I put a pen to that paper, it's artwork happening.
All
I've had a signature since I was in elementary school. I remember seeing my dad sign my report card and stuff like that. So I kind of just copied his and just added a junior to it. So that's how I got this signature. So it was really my dad's, but I just added the junior at the end. I used to always get in trouble in class for it, just signing it over and over again. So pen pal, my pen pal over there, my buddy. I feel like my first game is going to be very nerve-wracking in the beginning. It's going to be, I feel like I'm going to be filled with so many emotions, just nerves all over the place. But I feel like after the ball is kicked off, after I get my first hit, my first tackle, after they hit me one time, I'll be great. I'm very excited for that game in London. It's weird. I mean, being a kid, you could have told me I was going to be playing a football game in London. I would have laughed at you, kind of just brushed it to the side. Like now, to like put that in perspective, I'm going to be playing a football game in London. Like I never even been out the country, so like my first time being out the country, I'm going to be playing a football game. Something I love to do. My main focus is just like learn the playbook right now, just like get on the field to be able to make plays. And I mean, as long as we win the games, I really could care less about the individual accolades, because I feel as if we're doing good and great on the field, those are going to take care of themselves. So. So y'all gotta buy my trading card. That's what y'all gotta do.
All right, Ivan, were you able to get business taken care of?
I was taking care of business, and I got it taken care of. We have 17 winners tonight, Rob.
All right.
Hey, for the tickets, are you just going to hold them for the show, or are you going to mail them? How does that work?
I'll mail them.
Oh, you'll mail them? Okay. Yeah. All right. Cool. Well, yeah, we got 17 winners on tonight's show. So hopefully y'all stuck around and watched, especially because that last box and that last video segment were both worth watching. So I'm going to rattle off the winners. I'm going to rattle them off by Twitter handle, because remember, that's how we choose. If you are not already following us on Twitter after the show, at this point, I don't know what to do. But hey, if you're watching the show on Twitch, don't forget, if you have an Amazon Prime account, you can subscribe to our show for free. Just using that subscribe button and being logged into your Amazon account and following those steps. And also, huge thank you to all of our Twitch subscribers. We have a number of you that subscribe out of the goodness of your heart. Using the free subscription. So we will, now that Rob is back and we're getting warmed back up, we'll do some more Twitch exclusive giveaways in the near future as a thank you to everybody who subscribes there. That said, that helps offset a little bit of the shipping costs. Rob is going to be doing the shipping. So thank him for doing the shipping and be patient. He's still recovering a little bit. And make it easy by claiming your prize with the full amount of information we ask for. It's very simple. Email gogtslive@gogts.net with your name, your mailing address, key piece of information, your Twitter handle, and what you won, so we can match it up in the sheet real easy, real fast. Those four details to gogtslive@gogts.net. The first person to do that is going to win a pair of pairs of NSCC tickets, National Sports Collectors Convention tickets, is Jimmy Bay One. Congratulations, Jimmy Bay One. Look forward to seeing you at the National. And the second person who we will hopefully be seeing at the National, Musical Mel 72. We've seen you in the past. You were drawn and you replied. So awesome. Musical Mel 72. We'll be seeing you at the National. Next up, we've got the carryover auto from last week that went unclaimed. Alexander Barkov Shadowbox auto. That one is going to at Famous Grad. Congratulations, at Famous Grad. Now we're going into our tops segment of the show, starting off with the Mia Yim Matt Relic from WWE Women. That's going to Rubin Is Racing. Rubin Is Racing. Congratulations.
That's number 99, by the way. I failed to notice that in the beginning.
We missed that. Nice. So two numbered hits from that then. Pretty awesome. I'm telling you, I think that product might be shorter printed, because we don't usually have that much success in back-to-back boxes. We had two good boxes of that. The autograph, the Alexa Bliss autograph, That's going to at Sharpie360. Congratulations, Sharpie360. And then the other Topps giveaway we have tonight from The Mandalorian Series 2, Giancarlo Esposito, fantastic actor, as Moff Gideon in the series, the villain. That's going to AlexK245. Congratulations, AlexK245. Hey, this one was fun coming up in the randomizer. For the Luka Modric relic, he tweeted against our national, not against, but in response to our national ticket, saying he just can't win because he's in Canada. So he can't come to the national with the border stuff. That said, Chris Brown won. Congratulations. You at least won something on the show tonight. The Luka Modric relic. Congrats. I got through the entire show without a cup of water, and now it's coming back to haunt me.
Oh,
I was like, where's my water? Wait, that's why. All right, so we'll wrap this up. We're only about halfway through the giveaway winners, but won't get.
You can do it. You can do it.
Pushing through. If there's tears in my eyes, it's because of the tickle in my throat, not because of Chronicles, because the Mauro Tassotti auto was actually kind of cool with his years at AC Milan. That's going to QCR28. You got the Mauro Tassotti auto, QCR28. And then, hey, this guy is a real soccer fan, so I know that he'll love this card. The Ollie McBurney extra points gold auto numbered to possibly 10 is going to the real Nesquik. Congratulations, Nessie, the real Nesquik. I hope that you are, what did we say? Who do we say plays for? Scotland and what was it? Leeds? Burnham? I forget. Anyways, moving on to Panini Contenders draft picks. All of the hits. Six autographs. So this is a prospecting package all in one is going to Clevy for you. Clevy for you. Congratulations, Clevy for you. Could be C. Levy for you. I'm not sure. Clevy, C. Levy. Either way, you won six autographs from Panini Contenders. Instant NFL 2021 prospecting package. And now from Upper Deck, we've got six good hits to give away here, starting off with the hockey hits. I've got them sort of out of order. I've got the banner year from Seth Jones first. The banner year is going to PT Sports 19. PT Sports 19, you won that banner year, Seth Jones. The Alexander True relic is going to Troy Ayers. The dual relic of Nathan MacKinnon and Jack Eichel is going to Madden God 6688. Madden God 6688 got the dual relic. The Timothy Lejudai auto is going to Big Bear Bechtel. Congratulations, Big Bear Bechtel, on getting Timothy's rookie auto from Upper Deck Game Used Hockey. And then the Kaprizov rookie is going to Old Oaks LLC. You got the Kirill Kaprizov rookie. Did he win Rookie of the Year? Was that set? Will he win Rookie of the Year?
Is it done? He will.
Okay.
Hasn't been awarded yet, but he will.
I've been too busy watching golfers jaw at each other on Twitter to keep up with the NHL award season this year. That said, from the golf box, we've got the golf box. Everything but the one huge hit is going to C. Rutherford 042. You won five cards from the golf box from Upper Deck SP Game Used, right?
Yes.
Okay. I always get the SPs and the not SPs and the Xs and the SPXs. It can be a little confusing, but they're all awesome. And then finally, that Annika Sorenstam gold auto numbered to just 10. Wow. That's going to Zach in Philly. Congratulations, Zach. Thank you for watching every week. Most weeks Zach watches, so that's always fun. But hey, whether you watch every week or this is your first week, you can always win. So tune in again next week and tell your friends. Congratulations to all the winners. Hey, Rob, you've been on for an hour and 40 minutes. How do you feel, man?
I'm ready to go to bed.
Well, we thank you. Thank you for all of your work ripping for us and compiling all the news and all the video segments today. It's absolutely great to have you back, partner.
Thank you. Thank you. So thank you all for watching. Thank you to our reps at Upper Deck, Chris Carlin, Tracy Hackler at Panini, Emily Kless at Tops for hooking us up with some good stuff to look at tonight. Thanks for James Gale behind the scenes making us look good. Ivan Lovgren, all the work he does. Hey, we'll be back, Lord willing, next week with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live, the Hobbies web show. In the meantime, you know what to be doing. Always be collecting and be the change you want to see in the world. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.